Hi there, I'm Jack from Twinkl, and in today's video, we're taking a look at leap years. Why do we have leap years? Why does February have 29 days in a leap year? And why do we have leap years every 4 years? We'll answer these questions and take a look at some Twinkl leap year resources you can use to support your child's learning. You might remember this rhyme, 30 days has September, and so on. But what do those last three lines mean? Excepting February alone, which only has 28 days clear, and 29 in each leap year. Why does February have an extra day in a leap year? Well, believe it or not, it's because of Earth travelling around the Sun. One calendar year is 365 days, and the reason it's 365 days is because that's how long it takes for the Earth to orbit the Sun. But it turns out that it doesn't take exactly 365 days. In fact, it's closer to 365 days and a quarter. Now, we can't just have a quarter of a day, not just because we wouldn't get very much done. So we can't just leave these quarter days floating around. So every 4 years, we add these four quarters together to get one whole day. Every 4 years gives us our leap year, our extra day in the calendar when there is 366 days in a year. February goes from 28 days in a usual year to 29 days in a leap year. But why February? Well, leap years were first added in Roman times, and in the old Roman calendar, February was the last month of the year, so the extra day was just added on at the end of the year. Without adding that extra day in the leap year, all those quarter days would add up over time. Over hundreds and hundreds of years, our calendars would slowly get more and more wrong. All the seasons would fall eventually in the wrong months. We'd have Christmas in the summertime. So how do we know if a year is a leap year? Well, the simple trick is to divide by four. If it can divide by four, it's a leap year. The exception is years ending in 00, like 1800, 1900, or 2000. With these years, you need to find out if they divide by 400. If they can divide by 400, they are leap years. So 1600 and 2000 were leap years, but 1800 and 1900 were not. Twinkl have a number of resources to learn more about leap years. Start off with this PowerPoint. What is a leap year? In this PowerPoint, you will find an illustrated explanation about when and why we have leap years. But you'll also find some information on the traditions and superstitions that we have around the world about leap years. You'll also find out about some very lucky or unlucky people called leapers. What makes them special? There are a number of worksheets to help you learn all about how many days are in a week, how many months are in a year, or how to read a calendar. But there's also this worksheet specifically about leap years. Use the leap year maths rule to figure out if any given year is a leap year. Try and figure out all the leap years since you were born, and learn more about a couple from America who incredibly had three children born on the 29th of February in different leap years. Check out this series of maths lesson packs all about time, with this pack in the series focusing on knowing the number of days in a leap year. Or dive into Maths Mastery with this pack that also has a focus on leap years, encouraging the use of problem solving and reasoning. Finally, for more ideas on how to explore learning about the days of the week and the months of the year, check out this video from Twinkl Teacher Amy, packed full of ideas and activities. Thank you for watching. Make sure to like this video if you found it useful, and subscribe to the Twinkl Key Stage 2 YouTube channel.